Tyler, we're here in Minnesota, and you're a key part in organizing something that's pretty exciting.
Yeah, I guess I'm a key part. I just, you know, talked to a lot of the other racers that I know and have experienced some issues from the Lime issue in San Diego, and a lot of us felt it was necessary to get together and just talk over with Feld and just show that a lot of us have suffered over the last week. Our bikes have suffered, our riders have suffered, and just try to work together, try to make it safer for the riders, the teams, more beneficial for the riders, the teams, and Feld in general, to try to elevate this sport, try to make everybody happier, and I think it could be a beginning to a really good relationship, something that's been long overdue, I believe, between Feld and the racers and the teams. You know, some riders and some teams feel like, you know, Feld just has the upper hand all the time, or the promoter has the upper hand all the time, and we're getting screwed, this and that. I've worked closely with Feld in the past through the Arena Cross Series. I know that's not the case, so the main goal to get this together was get a group of riders on the same page, the same mindset, try to keep lawyers, OSHA, this and that, all these big threats that have been happening during the week, try to keep that out of the picture and try to work this out as a group with Feld and further the sport. So I think once we get these big agencies and stuff involved, I think it could be very bad. Feld might just close up shop and say we're done, it's too big of a headache. So none of us want that. We want to keep racing. We want to keep it safe and keep it fun and keep it exciting for the fans. So I think this is just a really good time for us riders and teams to get together and just try to further ourselves and further the sport in general.
What is the goal of this meeting this morning?
The goal of this meeting this morning is just to show a group of us are like-minded. You know, all of us riders, we race each other hard on the track. Some of these guys don't even like me, but they're here to support me and to support riders in general this weekend. And just to really get in and sit down with Feld and just open up a dialogue. It's not really to settle anything or do anything crazy like that. Nobody's trying to sit out races. Nobody's trying to protest, nothing crazy. It's just a riders co-op is what we're calling it, where us riders and Feld can cooperate together and try to do things for the better. Like I said, just to open up a dialogue about what happened last weekend and what we can do in the future to avoid things like that, and just to explore our options.
Cool. Thanks, man.
Thanks. I know for us, it might seem like it's not a lot and it's not enough. We don't have a lot of the big names here right off the bat. No big deal. If you think about it, there's 39 entries to the 450 class this weekend. If there's 11 of us here, that's pretty big majority of the entries this weekend. It looks pretty embarrassing if there's only 15 guys on each heat race starting gate for Feld. So just in general, having this many guys here, it doesn't look like a lot to us now, but I think it's a very, very, very good starting point, and this is a very serious matter. I don't think we need a million people here right off the bat, and I don't think we need to work anything out right off the bat. That's what we've been talking about here. I think the main goal for this weekend and this meeting is to not sound like a bunch of 20-year-old kids that were pissed off, that got burnt last weekend and stomping our feet, throwing a temper tantrum. We want to just come in and talk with Feld and Mike and the guys about what we experienced last weekend, one, and how to work through that in a positive manner, and also just kind of get our footing to show that we are a group, and this could be really big for not just us riders in general, but the teams as well, like really big for the teams, I believe, and also for Feld in general and the sport in general. I think it's very scary where we're at right now. A lot of people have been throwing around lawsuits and lawyers, but I think once you get that involved, it could get out of hand. And next thing you know, this whole sport could just get shut down because it became too big of a headache for the promoters. So I believe just starting this weekend and just kind of opening a dialogue, and we need to not forget about it each week as well. You know, we see each other every weekend, but our weeks go pretty quick. We fly home and we heal up from our burns, or our bike finally gets, you know, cleaned up. But we need to not forget about this. We need to try to meet if we can every weekend, if not every 2 weeks. Just open this up. And it could just be us actually sitting down like this and having coffee and donuts the morning of the race and whatever, and just hanging out and just talking, and then, you know, move on. But just show that we're a group sticking together, and then I think more guys will fall in, and then more things will happen, and then we can work on the big progress in the future.
All right, buddy, we got booted out of the meeting, but how did it go?
I think it went really well. The main goal was just, like I said, to get a group of guys together that are on the same page, and everybody wants to further the sport, and for the benefit of the riders, the teams, and Feld in general, and just make everything better for everybody. And it was great in even ways that I couldn't even imagine. Feld was very open to things, and us riders were able to share our thoughts with head guys at Feld, and it was good to just kind of have an actual riders meeting. Yeah. Not the riders meeting that we have on the track every weekend where we just kind of sit there and get lectured about the rules that we hear every weekend.
Yeah.
And it's something that we are going to continue to work on. Feld themselves and us riders are very into keeping the group organized and trying to keep up on it, and making a push for every weekend to try to meet in the same fashion in a room somewhere at the venue where we can have a quiet sit-down meeting with ourselves and Feld and address our concerns for the weekend and the future weekends. I think it's just coming to fruition here, and it can be really good for our sport in general and for our riders, for everybody to get their voices heard. But there's definitely a lot of work to be done behind the scenes still. A little bit more organization between the riders. So yeah, it's just cool to get our foot in the door and see that there was a group of 15 or more riders that, you know, believed in each other and everybody that showed up, and more people will continue to come. I've spoken to other riders still that were just amazed that we actually did it. So it's good.
So is this going to be a weekly thing, a bi-weekly thing?
I think right now we're going to focus on trying to be weekly, just so we can get, you know, the groundwork laid to try to get the organization organized.
Yeah.
You know, and then my hopes is to get to the point where we have, you know, a good footing, and then we can just do something where we meet before Anaheim 1, and then, you know, there's certain key people kind of in charge that communicate with Feld more, and then we only meet, you know, when there is an issue. Hopefully there's not, but we do something bi-weekly or every 3 weeks or something, maybe once a month, and we meet just to better the sport. Hopefully by this time next year we won't even have to really meet, because we'll have so much communication with Feld and riders in general all together that we won't have to meet too much, I hope. But like I said, right now we just need to really get the groundwork laid and build up a foundation of trust between the riders. The riders together need to trust each other and get everybody's ideas, and everybody know that they're looking out for each other, not just, you know, their own personal agendas, and then be able to push that with Feld.
Yeah. Was there any resolution made or reached on the Lime incident?
No resolution made on the Lime incident. I think that was some guy's goal today, but as I stated before, I don't think in the big picture, the ultimate goal was to not come to some kind of settlement, this and that, over the Lime incident. I think our goal was to get in there and show that some people are upset, and we have been adversely affected by the Lime incident last weekend. We know it wasn't Feld's, they didn't do it on purpose. Nobody went out there planning to cover everybody in battery acid.
Yeah.
But we are hurt by it, and we want to move forward with it and continue to race. That's the thing. We don't want to shut down the sport. We don't want agencies and lawyers involved that could risk the sport continuing on. So we just wanted to meet. I at least wanted to meet and show that we wanted to come to an agreement for that, get through that issue, and move forward to better the sport together.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So the initial offer, I'm told, was $5,000 for bike damage. Was that made only to privateers? Was it made to everyone that got wet?
I'm learning tonight that it was only to privateers, and I think only certain privateers. Not everybody got calls. Feld was very open about today at the meeting that they, if you have an issue, for instance, Chad said he didn't get offered. He said if you feel like you're entitled to something, then contact us directly and let's work something out. I think that the real problem we're at right now is trying to figure out, for instance, some privateers have kit suspension that is ruined, which is $10,000 when you buy it new. Other privateers don't have kit suspension, didn't spend that much money. So it's hard to come up with a set number that's going to be good for everyone. The privateers were affected, but there's also Chad Reed was affected. You know, Cooper Webb was affected, you know, adversely with these rashes, but they don't own their bikes, you know.
Yeah.
So does $5,000 go to the team and then the rider as well for his pain and suffering, or how do they figure out what amount and what in general is going to be good for everyone in the whole picture of things? So right now we're just at the point where, like I said, we just got to group together. We need to communicate more with the riders, each other, and come to come up with some ideas. And that was the main goal for this meeting today, and then the goal for this weekend was to come together and come up with ideas and something that's not going to screw anybody, not Feld, not riders, anybody. We want to better things for everybody. We want to get through this issue and better the sport in general.
Cool. Oh, yeah, I know you got to get on the track, but thanks for the update, and congratulations.
Right on. Thank you.